Red Hat OpenShift AI is a portfolio of products to make AI, ML, and intelligent applications an achievable reality for modern enterprises. We've had lots of exciting updates, and today I'm going to give you a quick overview. Let's take a look. Red Hat OpenShift AI is available as both a managed service or as a self-managed offering. If you've purchased the managed service, then you can install it as an add-on to OpenShift Dedicated or the Red Hat OpenShift service on AWS. Here on my OpenShift Dedicated cluster, the OpenShift AI tile is available in the Add-ons tab. From there, just click to install. The self-managed installation is just as easy. On your OpenShift cluster, OpenShift AI can be found on Operator Hub. Once installed, the link to the application is available in the OpenShift Application Launcher. This will launch the OpenShift AI dashboard. On the dashboard, we can see enabled applications such as Jupyter, which come built in and supported by Red Hat. The Explore link will take you to a variety of available applications. These include Red Hat Managed Cloud Services, Partner Managed Services, and Self-Managed Software. Click on any of the tiles to learn more about each application and how to get started. The Resources link offers tutorials and documentation on how to use OpenShift AI, including partner software. Quick Starts are embedded in the application itself and offer an inline tutorial experience. Here we can see the tutorial for creating a Jupyter notebook. Let's get started and take a look at a typical workflow. Data science projects are where the real work begins. In a project, you'll see several sections, including workbenches, storage, data connections, pipelines, and model servers. Workbenches are where you'll start a development environment such as Jupyter Notebooks. Let's start there and create one. First, I can pick a notebook image from a list of available images. There are several choices here built and supported by Red Hat, which include updated secure libraries, including CUDA, TensorFlow, PyTorch, and more. I'm going to choose my own custom-built PyTorch image, which includes all the packages I'll need for this demo. Here, I can add resource selection for CPU, memory, and GPUs. The environment variables section is useful for injecting dynamic information that I don't want to save in my notebook. I'm going to add this login token for future use. I'm also going to add some additional space and create a new storage volume. In this demo, we'll be using object storage. I've already created that data connection and can add it here so it'll be ready for use. Now, I can click to start the workbench. So now that you've started a new workbench, what can we do with it? First and foremost, they're a good place to connect to data and do self-documented experimentation and analysis. Sometimes exploring data is all that's needed, but if your goal is to get an AI/ML service into production, there's lots more to do. Let's walk through a workflow where we can take a model, train it with our own data, and then deploy it as a service. For this project, we'll try text-to-image generation. We'll start using an open-source model from Hugging Face. Then we'll train it using open-source code from GitHub, and then we'll save it and create a model server. For any project, we want to save our work in history, so let's start in Git. I've already got this project in GitHub, so let's clone my project and get started. After a bit of setup, the next step is to download the training data for use. Because we use the foundation model, we don't need that much new data to fine-tune it. This is Teddy, and we want to generate his picture. Now we're going to kick off a training job using the data we just downloaded. After the training job is complete, we can reload the model and test inference again. And there you go. Now you can see the fine-tuned model is generating pictures of Teddy. In order to serve this model, we need to save it in a format that's easily usable. Different model servers can recognize a variety of formats. We're going to save our model in ONNX format, one of the most portable. This notebook will convert our model to ONNX as part of the pipeline and upload them to our object storage. Now, to do this in a repeatable manner, we can create a data science pipeline. We can create a pipeline from a single notebook or Python file. We can also make a complex pipeline with lots of steps. Once we've triggered a pipeline run, we can view its progress and recreate as many runs as we need. And now we can serve the model using the same data connection we used from our notebook. Let's go ahead and configure our application to call our new model API. Here's my application, and I'm going to add the gRPC URL as an environment variable. Now the application can call our served models to generate pictures. That was a quick tour of Red Hat OpenShift AI. Our goal is to make your data science projects successful not just as experiments, but as part of the next generation of intelligent applications. I hope you found this brief introduction useful, and we have a ton of new features coming. But for now, I can't wait to see what you create with Red Hat OpenShift AI.